Hi, I'm Christian.
Hey, Mohan. Good evening, Mohan.
Good evening, Ramakrishnan. Good evening. So, only you have joined. So, let's wait for 5 minutes. Okay?
Yes, sure.
Yeah. Thanks, Ramakrishnan. Thank you. Hello guys. Very good evening to everyone. So I have Meghna, Ramakrishnan and Rashmi. So three participants have joined. So let's start the session. Okay. Let me mute every one of you. Okay. Let me mute all of you, and if there is any doubts, you can ping me in. Yeah, as usual. Let me check if the recording is on. Yes, the recording is on. Okay. So today we are going to see regular expressions. Okay. So what is the use of regular expression? It's used for pattern matching. Okay, this regular expression is used for pattern matching. Alright, so in order to use the regular expression, we need to import a package called RE. Okay, we need to import the package called RE. Okay, so now first let's do the simple match. Okay, so before that, let me write something like while of true. Okay, so INP, that is input is equal to input of, or else it's add string. Okay, so string is equal to input of enter any string. Okay, and I can just print it like, and before that, if not of string, then I can just say break. Okay, then I can print string entered by user. I can write like this. So what is the use of this particular statements? That is, if I am not entering any input, okay, if I am not entering any input, this particular loop will break. Okay, see here, let me just execute enter any string. If I enter ABC, it will work. That is, it will continue. Okay, DEF will continue. Okay, if I am not entering any input, it will come out. Okay, so why I am using this logic is, that is, with the same regular expression pattern, we will be giving various inputs. Okay, only for that I am using this particular logic. Okay, so from now we are going to see regular expression. Alright, so first one, let me see simple match. Okay, that is, now I'm not going to, one second guys, one second guys, please be online. I got a call from screen people, one second. Sorry guys, actually I got a call from screen people. Okay. Yeah, so now first we are going to see simple match. That is nothing but, okay, we are going to check whether the string, whether the given string or whether the input is present in the string or not. Okay, it is like checking substring in a string. Okay, see here, like if of rg dot search, okay, and let me write Python and then string. All right, then I can write Python is present, else print Python is not present, like this. Okay, now let me give the input, like Python script, like this. So you can, here you can see Python is present. Okay, it doesn't matter that that is present in the stream. It can, see, it can be present at the end as well. Okay, the basic thing is it should be present, that's it. The basic thing is it should be present. Okay, and then, see, for example, I am writing like script. So now it will tell you Python is not present in the stream. Okay, and also if I enter like this, see here, I'm searching for small p, but here it is capital P. Okay, if I'm searching for that, it will tell Python is not present, because this is case sensitive. Okay, in order to perform case insensitive search, what should I do is I have to give re.i. Okay, re.i. All right, so so like now if I give the input in any way, I see here Python script, no problem, it will say Python is present. Actually, see, Python is present. Okay, similarly script Python, okay, no problem. All right, so when you include re.i in the condition, it is nothing but ignore case. It is nothing but ignore case, actually. All right, so this is just a simple match without using any regular expression patterns. I didn't use any pattern so far. Okay, from now on we are going to use patterns. Okay, from now on we are going to use patterns. Okay, so now let me write. Okay, now let me write. Okay, first patterns are anchors. Here we have two patterns. One is cap symbol. It indicates starts with. Okay, cap symbol indicates starts with. And dollar symbol indicates ends with. Okay, now let me write the pattern. So if re dot search, and then I am giving cap Python. Okay, I am giving cap Python, and then string. Okay, I can write cap symbol Python space satisfied, like this, else print cap symbol Python not satisfied, like this. Okay, so when this will be satisfied, when this will be satisfied, that is when the string is starting with the Python, only then it will be satisfied, otherwise it will not, because of this particular cap symbol. Okay, now if I execute, like Python is efficient, see here cap symbol is satisfied. Okay, for example, okay, for example, if I write script is Python, all right, you can see it is not satisfied because Python is present at the end. Okay, all right, then now if you want to check ends with, okay, I can write Python and then dollar. Okay, Python, and then dollar. This indicates, okay, this particular word Python should be, sorry, this the string should be ended with Python. Okay, so if you give Python dollar, that means the string should be ended with Python. Only then it will be satisfied. Okay, see now, like for example, if I give script is Python, now you can see starting with is not satisfied, but ending with is satisfied. Okay, and if I write Python script, you can see Python, this is starting with is satisfied, but ending with is not satisfied. Okay, and if I just say Python, both will be satisfied because it's starting with Python and ending with Python. And Python is Python. This will also be satisfied. See? Okay. Hope it is clear. Okay. Hope it is clear to everybody. Okay. And next form is, I am going to give just cap symbol dollar. I am going to give cap symbol dollar. That's it. Okay, what this will be matching? If you give this one, the empty string will be matching. Okay, the empty string will be matched. Okay, for that, I should just comment this one. Let's comment this. Okay, let's comment this. Because if I enter empty string, it will not come until this. That's why I'm commenting this out. Okay, so now let me just execute it now. If I enter nothing, then the last one will be satisfied. This indicates the empty string. Okay, cap symbol dollar indicates the empty string actually. Okay, for example, even if I have space here, this will not be satisfied. Okay, even if I have some space here, it will not be satisfied. Okay, all right. Okay, then let me remove this comment. And next form, okay, the last form with anchors. Let me give just cap symbol and then dollar and then Python. Okay, cap symbol, Python and then dollar, that's it. Okay, I have added both actually, that is starting with Python ending with. Okay, this indicates the string should contain only Python. That is, it is like exact match actually. Okay, it is like exact match. See, for example, if I execute just Python, okay, I'm entering the word only Python. So you can see the last one is satisfied. And also the first two are satisfied. But if I write Python is Python, okay, for this particular input, you can't see the last one is getting satisfied. See here, the last one is not satisfied. Because it will be satisfied only if it contains only Python. Okay, it will be satisfied only if it contains Python. All right, this is the reason. Okay. Okay. Any doubt? Any doubt? Okay. Okay. So you can ignore case two. Yes. Actually, for that you have to give re.py. Only then it will ignore the case. Otherwise, it will not. Okay, Ramakrishnan? Okay. Then, next set of patterns is nothing but range of characters. Okay. Next is nothing but range of characters. That is, I can give 0 to 9. Okay, it matches any single digit. Okay, if you give 0 to 9, it matches any single digit. And similarly, if you give small a to small z, it matches any single lowercase alphabet. And next one, capital A to capital Z. That is, it matches any single uppercase alphabet. Okay, and next one, small a to small z, capital A to capital Z. Okay, that means it matches any alphabet. Okay, any single alphabet actually. It's not more than one. It will match only single alphabet. And the last one, I can say 0 to 9, small a to small z, capital A to capital Z. So it matches any single alphanumeric. Okay, any single alphanumeric. Okay, all right. So now let's see few examples with this. Okay, let me write. Let me write, that is 0 to 9, A to Z, capital A to capital Z. Okay, so if I give like this, what happens is, okay, if I give like this, what happens is, our input should contain, okay, our input should contain only three characters. It should start with a number, okay, followed by one lowercase alphabet and followed by one uppercase alphabet. Okay, it should have only three characters, that's it, and not more than that. Okay, see now, if I execute this one, I can say 5A capital A, that will be satisfied. See here, it is satisfied. 5A capital A, it is satisfied. Okay, and similarly, if I interchange it, 5 capital A, it will not be satisfied. It will not be satisfied because it should be the order. First, it should have one number, then followed by one lowercase and followed by one uppercase. Okay, it should be in the order actually. Okay, and okay, any doubts so far? Any doubts so far? Okay, and next one we have. Yeah. So next one we have. Thanks, Ramakrishnan. Next one we have like meta characters. Okay, next one is nothing but meta characters. Okay, that is first one is plus. It matches one or more occurrence of the previous character. One or more occurrence of the previous character. That is one or more occurrences of the previous character. Then star. It matches zero or more occurrences of the previous character. Okay, and then question mark. Question marks is nothing but matches zero or one occurrence of the previous character. That is one too many, zero too many, and zero to one. Okay, previous character. Okay, let's see. Let me write now. Let me write. That is A, B plus C. Okay, A, B plus C. All right. And then let me write for star also. Let me write for star and question mark also. This is star and this is question mark. A B star C, A B star C, A B star C, and A B question mark C, A B question mark C, and then A B question mark C. Okay, so now that is first let's check AB plus C. Okay, that is it indicates, okay, that is between A and C minimum one B can be present or maximum A number of B's, that is at least one B should be present between A and C. So what we have written, if it is plus, it matches one or more occurrences of the previous character. Right, what is the previous character here? It's nothing but B. Okay, it's nothing but B. So it matches one or more occurrences of the previous character. All right, and next one is AB star C, that is between A and C B can be present or cannot be present. B is optional. Okay, and B can be present for any number of times, no problem at all. Okay, and if it is question mark between A and C, B can be present or cannot be present. That's it. If it is present, it should be present for only once. If it is B question mark, it should be present for only once actually. That's it. That is, plus means at least one B, maximum A number of B. Star means B is optional. B can be zero or more. And question mark is also optional, but zero or one. Okay, see, let me give the input, various inputs. First, let me give A, C. Now, which will be satisfied? Plus will not be satisfied because at least one B should be present. And star will be satisfied because B is optional. And question mark will be satisfied because B can be present or cannot be present. That is zero or one occurrence. Okay. See here, plus is not satisfied, star is satisfied, and question mark is satisfied. Okay. And similarly, if I say like A, B, C, all three will be satisfied. Plus will be satisfied, yes, one occurrence. And star will be satisfied, yes, one occurrence. And question mark will be satisfied, yes, one occurrence. All three will be satisfied. Okay. Now, if I enter A, B, B, C. Now, if you enter, only plus will be satisfied and star will be satisfied, but not question mark, because in question mark means between A and C only one B should be present. See here, not satisfied. Okay, so these are the three various stuff. Okay, these are the three various stuffs actually. That is plus, star, and question mark. All right. Okay, any doubts with this? Any doubts with this? Yeah, thank you. And next one we have, okay, next one we have quantifiers. Okay, that is here we can mention the boundaries. Like, for example, if I say this is curly brace actually, okay, it is like matches M occurrences of the previous character. Okay, and also I can write M comma N. I can say matches minimum, this is exactly M occurrences, exactly M occurrences. This is like minimum M and maximum N occurrences of the previous character. Okay, so now let me write. Okay, now let me write. So here, instead of question mark, I'm just placing 3. Okay, instead of question mark, I'm just placing 3. Okay, and in the next example, I'm just placing it like 1, 3. 1, 3. Okay, like this. That is, it is like between A and C, only 3B should be present. That's it. Between A and C, only 3B should be present. And the second one, between A and C, minimum 1B, maximum 3Bs can be present. Okay, see here. Now, let me give various inputs. First, let me give ABC. Okay, 1B is present. Right? So, second one will be satisfied, but not the first one. See here, not satisfied, satisfied. Okay, now let me give A double B C. Similarly, first one will not be satisfied, but second one will be satisfied. Okay, now let me give A B B B C. That is 3 B's and then C. Okay, A triple B and then C. So now, if I execute it, you can see both are satisfied. Okay, both are satisfied because 3 B's are present actually. All right, so these are called as quantifiers. That is, you can mention the exact number of occurrences or range of occurrences. Okay, you can mention the exact number of occurrences or range of occurrences of the previous character. You can mention like that. Okay, that is called quantifiers. Okay, and next one is nothing but choices and alternatives. Okay, choices and then alternatives. That is, if I say like A, B, C, okay, within the square bracket, if I say A, B, C, it is nothing but matches any one of A, B, and then C. Any one of A, B, and C. And if I have, like, within the square bracket, if you mention cap symbol, like this, okay, it is like matches other than A, B, and C. See, like, if you mention cap symbol, okay, outside square brackets, that is nothing but starting with. If you mention the square cap symbol, okay, within the square bracket, it is nothing but, okay, it is exclusive. That is other than those particular characters. Okay, so now let me just write this. Okay, first let me just copy one. I think that should be fine. Okay, and then let me write. So now let me write B, C, D, or else let me write 1, 2, 3, and then C. Okay, A, 1, 2, 3, and then C. Okay. Let me give this one. Okay, and then alternatives. Let me give it. Alright. Okay. So here I have to mention inside the cap symbol. This is called alternatives. Okay. Alternatives means other than. Other than. Okay. So now if I execute it, I can say A1C. Now what happens? The first one will be satisfied, but not the second one. Because any one of 1, 2, 3 should be present. Okay. Now, A, 2, C. See, this is satisfied. And A, 3, C. This is satisfied. Okay. All right. A, 1, 2, 3, and then C. It will be satisfied. All right. Okay. And now, if I enter any other character apart from 1, 2, 3, let me enter A, 4, C. This will be satisfied. Okay, not only numbers. For example, if I enter this character, A, percentage, C. Second one will be satisfied. Okay, that is, other than 1, 2, 3, any character can be accepted for the second one. Okay. Any character can be accepted for the second one. All right. This is for choices and then alternatives. Okay. Hope it is clear to everybody. Let me wait for some 10 seconds. So please let me know whether you have understood this. Okay, thank you guys. And next one, we are going to see dot, okay, dot operator or dot character, that is this one, okay. So this one is nothing but matches any single character, okay. It matches any single character, okay. If it is dot, it matches any single character. Okay, see here, let me give cap symbol A dot C dot symbol. Okay, that is in between A and C, any character can be present, any one character can be present. Okay, any one character can be present. C, A to C, satisfied. A 3 C, satisfied. But if I enter AC, it will not be satisfied. Okay, if I enter AC, it will not be satisfied. Okay, any one character can be anything. Can be special character, can be number, can be spaces, like that. Okay, anything. Alright, now, if I say, like A dot start C, okay, that is in between A and C, any number of characters can be present for any number of times. Any character can be present for any number of times. Okay, see now, like I am writing A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then some characters, okay, some characters I am giving, okay, and some other alphabets I am giving. And then last C. Okay, that is in between A and C, any character can be present. Okay, there is no limit actually. That is for A dot star C. Okay, and also if I say AC also, it will be satisfied. Because star represents 0 or more. Right? Star represents 0 or more. Got it? Okay. Hope it is clear. Okay, and next one, it's groupings. Okay, next one is groupings. All right, so it is like, so when we say AB plus C, okay, when we say AB plus C, what does that mean? That is between A and C, B can be present at least once. That is what AB plus C is, right? Now, let me give like this. AB, okay, and then quantifier 3 and then C. Okay, I am putting like this. Okay, AB, quantifier 3 and then C. Okay. Let me copy this, guys. One second. Okay, AB, quantifier 3 and then C. Okay, so now if I execute this one, okay, see here, AB, 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 C. Okay, AB, 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 C. That is, these group, the set of characters which are enclosed in parentheses can be repeated for 3 times. If I didn't include this particular parentheses, it will check only for B, whether it is repeated for 3 times or not. See now. So, AB, 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 C. See? Satisfied. Okay. So, it is like this. It is called groupings. Okay. So, you can have some set of characters that can be repeated for n number of times. that is called groupings. All right. Okay. Clear? Clear so far? Hello, guys. So far, everything is clear, right? Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Meghna and Ramakrishnan and Rashmi. Thank you. Who is the next person I join? Sandhya. Okay. Sandhya, are you clear? Yes. Okay. Thank you. And next one. Okay. Next one is. Character range escape sequences. Okay, that is, these are the alternatives. Okay, like if it is slash D, it indicates it matches any single digit. And if it is slash capital D, okay, it matches other than digits. Slash capital D means other than digits. Okay, slash small w, that means, okay, matches any alphabet, that is alphanumeric characters 0 to 9, A to Z, capital A to Z, and then underscore. Okay, it matches any one of these characters. Okay, this also matches single digit only, single character only. Okay, and next one, if I say slash capital W, that means other than these characters. Okay, other than these characters. All right, and then slash S means spaces and tabs. Okay, and if I say slash capital S, it's nothing but other than spaces and then tabs. Okay, other than spaces and then tabs actually. Okay, all right. So let's have some example with this. Let's have some example for this. Okay, and let me write slash D 10. Okay, slash D 10. What is this query? That is any mobile number. Right, any mobile number can be matched. See, for example, let me enter one mobile number. Okay, let me enter some mobile number here. Okay, see here, it is satisfied. For example, if I enter just 5 digits, okay, it is not satisfied. Okay, all right, and next one, and also, like, let me give now, like, grouping, that is slash D slash S 2 times and then slash D 4. That is, this is a groupings, right? Slash D slash S 2 times slash D 4. Okay, so can you guess what is this number? That is 4 digits, space for 2 times, and at last only 4 digits should be there. Okay, see now, let me enter the input. That is 9876 space 5232 space 1012. Okay, so it looks like other number. Okay, 12 digits. Okay, see. Oh, one second, guys. I have made some mistakes. I have made some mistake. Not satisfied. How come 9876 space 1234 space 4568? Not satisfied. I'm giving some space here. Okay. So let me give 4/S/D4/S/D4. Okay, so now let me check it. Okay, now let me check it. Okay, like 9876 space 5243 space 1452. Yeah, now it is satisfied. Okay, now it is satisfied. All right. Okay, so this is like other number we are for other number we are checking the pattern. Okay, for other numbers we are checking the pattern. And also one more also I can write. One more government ID. Okay, one more the government ID also I can write. Okay, like that is I can write capital A to capital Z 5 times. Okay, /D4 and then at last one capital Z, one capital letter actually. Okay, so what can I do for this is, this is called a PAN card number, if you remember. Okay, remember the format, it's a PAN card number actually. All right, see now, like A B C D E 1 2 3 4 F, it is satisfied. This is the PAN card number is satisfied. Okay, for the string that we have given. All right. Okay, so these are the various types of patterns. Okay, these are the various types of regular expression patterns. Okay, like from the beginning, if I want to summarize, like anchors, range of characters, meta characters, quantifiers, choices and alternatives, dot character, groupings, and then character range escape sequences. All right, okay, yeah. So Ramakrishnan has one question: what is the best way to remember all those? Okay, so I will tell you some shortcut to remember these. Okay, I will tell you some shortcut to remember these. Okay, okay. See, first remember anchor, starting. Okay, starting point. Let's take like that. Anchors, okay, and now it is like starting with P. Okay, that is over here. If you see over here, if you see, I can't decide the dynamic starting character. Whatever some character I am giving it over here, and whatever character I am giving it over here, it should be fixed, right? I can't tell with these patterns, I can't tell it should start with any alphabet, it should end with any number, like that. Okay, now we have the continuous. So to achieve that, you should know range of characters. Okay, like any character, any number, any alphanumeric character you can give. All right, so now there is some disadvantage for this. For example, if you want to match some 100 characters, okay, you should give 100 times like this, 0 to 9, 0 to 9, 0 to 9 for 100 times. Okay, then meta characters will come into the picture, because with this we can have any number of characters. Okay, it is not required to mention each and every time. Okay, like this, plus star and question mark. Star we know, like zero or more always. Okay, if you know Unix, it will be like that. Okay, plus means remember is like at least once, like that. And question mark, you know, right? Ternary operator, remember ternary operator, this conditional operator, either this or that, that is choice, zero or one, like that you can remember. And there is some disadvantage with this, that is we can't set the maximum limit. Okay, we can't set the maximum limit. We can say more occurrences, but we can't say 10 occurrence, 20 occurrence, or some range of occurrences. So for this, quantifiers will come into the picture. Okay, m occurrence, or minimum m, maximum n occurrence, like that. Okay, and choices. That is, we know the range of characters. That is called choices. Okay, and choices opposite to is alternatives. That is, this is like matching these, that is matching any one of these characters. And this is like other than these characters. That's it. Okay. And dot character groupings and all, like by practice, you will be bringing in. Okay. And if you see this, you should remember only DWS. Small letter means matches. Okay. Matches the digit. Capital means other than, always. See, capital D means other than 0 to 9. Capital W means other than 0 to 9, small a to z, capital A to z, and then underscore. And capital S means other than spaces and tags. That's it. So now we have covered. Okay, Ramakrishnan? And one thing is, it will come by practice. Yeah? Okay. Okay, guys. All right. So far we have seen the expressions. Okay. Now we are going to see functions. Okay, so first one, we are going to see difference between search and match. Difference between search and match. Okay, difference between search and match. That is, I can write, okay, let me take the pattern. Okay, so before that, let me explain. Okay, that's fine. So if re dot search, okay, let me give the pattern like slash d 3, okay, slash d 3, and then string, okay, and then I can write search satisfied, else print search not satisfied. Okay. And now let me copy the same pattern. Let me copy the same pattern with the match. Okay, now let me execute this. Okay, let me execute with 1, 2, 3. Okay, you can see both are satisfied. And let me give 1, 2, 3 is the number. Now also both are satisfied. Okay, now I am going to write number is 1, 2, 3. Now you can see the difference. That is, search is satisfied, but match is not satisfied. Okay, search is satisfied, but match is not satisfied. Okay, because search looks for the pattern anywhere in the string. Okay, search looks for the pattern anywhere in the string, but match looks for the pattern only at the beginning of the string. That is the difference. Okay, see here, that is in the previous example I gave at the beginning actually. 1, 2, 3 is the number. Okay, that's why both are satisfied. Search and satisfied, match is satisfied. But the next one I gave number is 123. Okay, but for this only search is satisfied but match is not. So match will always check for the pattern at the beginning. That is the difference between search and match. All right. Okay. All right. Fine with this. Yeah. And next function, we are going to see find all. Okay, next function we are going to see find all. That is, it will find all the matched patterns. Consider, okay, like we can't say only one particular substring will be matched with the given pattern. Okay, lot of strings will be present. Okay, lot of substrings will be having the same pattern. See, for example, all matched. Okay, so re dot find all. Okay, let me give this one itself. All right, and then string. Okay, so now let me print this all underscore matched, and then type of all underscore matched. Okay, so now if I execute this one, I can see, okay, ABC 1 2 3. Okay, let me give space 1 2 3, and DEF 1 2 3, GHI 4 5 6. Okay, and something JKL and something. Okay, so now if you see the string, okay, so slash D within curly brace 3, you can see here, here, here. That is, in three places the parents are matched actually. So it will extract all the substrings which are satisfied with the given pattern. See, now you can see like this 1 2 3 comma 1 2 3 comma 4 5 6. Okay, it will extract the substrings that is satisfied with the given pattern. Okay, it will be like that. There is 1 2 3 comma 1 2 3 comma 4 5 6. It will be all right. Okay, and next function is like split. Okay, SPTSTR RE dot split. Okay, we give the same pattern and then string. Okay, so print. Okay, print SPT underscore STR, and then I can write type of SPT underscore STR. That is, now what happens is, based on this particular delimiter, this pattern has a delimiter, and it will extract the value from there. See, now let me just give ABC, same thing I'm giving. Okay, ABC, DEF 4 5 6, and GHI. See here, now it will split the string based on the delimiter, this pattern. Okay, based on the delimiter, this will split the string actually. Okay, based on the delimiter, this will split the string to list. Okay, so remember the string dot split method, what we had done in that, like based on some fixed character we split the strings. But here we are considering the delimiter as the, sorry, we are considering the pattern as the delimiter. Okay, and then we are splitting the string based on that. Okay, and then we are splitting the string based on that actually. All right. Okay, and similarly, next one, the last one in regular expression is called sub. Okay, that is REPSTR is equal to RE dot sub. Okay, that is, it is like find and replace. Okay, it is like find and replace actually. Let me replace with 555. Okay, number. Okay, 555, and then let me give string. All right, now if I print REPSTR, and then I can give type of REPSTR like this. Okay, so now what happens is, this slash D3, that is, the matched patterns will be replaced with the 555. Okay, the matched pattern will be replaced with the 555. Okay, see now, let me give the same input, like ABC 1 2 3, DEF 4 5 6, and then GHI. Now you can see the matched patterns has been replaced with these numbers. Okay, alright. Okay, so these are the different types of functions and different types of patterns that is available in regular expression. Okay, this is the most important module. Okay, this is the these are the most important core module in Python actually, because if you understand the concepts really well, okay, in all the scripting languages it's all same. It differs only in the way it is being implemented. Okay, it differs only in the way it is being implemented. That's it. But the concept wise, it's all same. If you take Shell script, if you take Perl script, if you take Python, if you take Ruby, if you take PHP, okay, everywhere it is same. But the way in which it differs is the syntax. That's it. Alright. Okay. Okay, guys. Any doubts? So with this, we are completing regular expressions part. Okay. Any doubts, guys? Any doubts? So let me wait. Let me wait. Okay, Ramakrishnan is fine. Okay. What about others? Meghna, Rishmi, Soundarya. Rishmi is fine. Soundarya is fine and Meghna is fine. Thank you. Thanks everyone. Thank you. Thank you. Okay guys, so can we take a break? So and then we'll see decorators and generators today. Yeah? Okay guys. So we'll meet at line 9:45. Yeah? Okay. I'm muting myself. Let me mute myself. Hello guys, can you start? Yeah, okay. So now we are going to see decorators.ui. okay, so what do you mean by decorators? Okay, see, first let me write one simple code. Okay, first let me write one simple code like decorators. Like let me define some two functions like calcsqr. Okay, and then let's say max num, and I can write print I am in calcsqr, and then let me just calculate square list is equal to this. You all know this is nothing but, okay, list comprehension. That's it, nothing else. Okay, for range of 1 comma max num plus 1. Okay, and then I'm going to return sqr underscore list, and then sim, and then again I'm going to write cal cube. Okay, max num, and then I'm just going to write like I am in calc cube, like this, and then I can write cube underscore list is equal to num star star 3 for num in range of 1 comma max num plus 1, and then return cube underscore list. Okay, like this. All right, and now let me call this function, like let's say square calc underscore sqr of 5, and similarly print what is that cube. Okay, calc underscore cube of what is that, of 5. Okay, let me do it like this. All right, so now let me execute this one. You can see it is getting printed like I am in calc sqr, and then it is printing the square of 10 numbers, and then similarly it is displaying cube. Okay, I am in calc cube, and then it is displaying the cube of 5 numbers. Okay, so now I want to measure the time taken by each and every function. Now I want to measure the time taken by each and every function. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to write, okay, start some variable, okay, like time dot time. All right, and similarly before returning I'm going to write like end is equal to time dot time, something like this. Okay, and then let me have sleep for some 5 seconds. Okay, let me have some sleep for some 5 seconds. There is time dot sleep for 5. That is 5 seconds. This particular program, sorry, this particular block will be paused. Okay, and then I am just printing, okay, print calc sqr took, okay, calc sqr took, I can write string of, okay, string of start minus, sorry, end minus start. That is, I am, because time dot time will give you in seconds. Okay, time dot time will give you in seconds actually. Okay, so I'm going to write end minus start. Okay, and then I'm just calculating in milliseconds, like into 1000. That is n minus start into 1000. Okay, and then I'm just giving like milliseconds to complete something. Okay, some string actually. That's it. All right. So now let me execute this one. Okay. So calc SQR is sleeping for 5 seconds, and here you can see calc SQR took 5000 milliseconds to complete. Okay. And the same functionality. That is, I have some 100 functions, and I want to measure the time taken by each and every particular function. Okay, I want to measure the time taken by each and every function. Okay, what should I do? I have to implement the same steps in each and everything. Like again, I have to write start is equal to time dot time. Okay, and then here again, let me write time dot sleep of 5. Okay, end is equal to time dot time, like this. Okay, and then I can write print calc cube took plus str of end minus start, okay, into 1000 plus milliseconds to complete, like this. All right, milliseconds to complete. Okay, so now if I execute this one, I can say, see here, I mean, is calc SQR. It is running actually. See, calc SQR took some 5000 milliseconds. Calc cube also, it takes some same time actually. Okay, because this process will take much faster. Okay, so now if you observe the coding, okay, you can see some redundancy of code. Okay, you can see some particular part of code is getting repeated, like start is equal to time dot time is getting repeated, time dot sleep of 5 is getting repeated, end is equal to time dot time is getting repeated, and then this one is getting repeated, right? And also this print statement is getting repeated, right? Okay, so these much things are getting repeated actually. So in order to avoid the code redundancy, that is repetency, okay, or not to remove the code duplication, we are going to the concept of decorators. Okay, like now I am going to have something called decorators here. Okay, time it. All right, let's have function name. All right, this function names are nothing but calc sqr, calc cube. Like in whatever functions the decorators has been applied. Okay, those function names are called this argument. Okay, now we are going to declare wrapper function, and then I'm going to have star args, star star kw args. You all know what is the meaning of this. That is any number of parameters, right? Any number of parameters. This is a generic form of parameters actually, if you remember. That is n number of functional arguments, n number of keyword arguments. That is, these are nothing but the parameters to this function. Okay, and now I can write, okay, now I can write, just say print I am in plus, okay, function name dot underscore underscore name underscore underscore. Yesterday we have seen this variable, right? Underscore underscore name underscore underscore. That is, it will print the function name actually. All right, and then now I am going to calculate start is equal to time dot time, and then I am calling the function. That is f underscore return is equal to, okay, function name pass the parameters star args, star star kw args. Okay, and then I am calling some function like end is equal to time dot time, and before that let me have time dot sleep of 5. Okay, so now I'm going to print it. Print, okay, function underscore name dot underscore underscore name underscore underscore. Okay, I can write took, okay, str of end minus star into 1000. Okay, 1000 milliseconds to complete. Okay, 1 second, guys. I just minimize this chat window. Yeah, milliseconds to complete. Okay, all right. And then return of f underscore return, and I need to return wrapper. That is, I will explain the flow. Okay, then you will understand it. Then you can understand easily. All right. So now I'm going to remove all the lines from here. Okay, similarly here as well. Because these are all code redundancy, right? Code duplication, no? So I'm just going to remove everything. Okay, now it has been removed. Okay, now it has been removed. Now let me execute it. Nothing will happen. Nothing will happen because we have just defined the decorator, but not yet applied. Let me apply time underscore 8. I have applied only to calcsqr. That's it. Okay, now let me explain it. See, now I am in calcsqr is printed. That is, this one is printed. Okay, and calcsqr took some milliseconds to complete, and then it is printing square. Okay, now let me do one thing. Okay, now let me just print dash here. Okay, something like this, and then let me see. Okay, that is, now what I'm going to do is, okay, now I'm going to apply this decorator to this function as well, that is calcube as well. Okay, now let me run it. Okay, now let me run that. See, calcsqr took some this much of seconds, and then calcube took this much of seconds. Okay, this should be here at the bottom. Only then it will be fine. Otherwise, it will not be proper. Yeah. Okay. All right. So, what is happening here? How the execution flow is happening? Okay. That is, now when I call this calcsqr of 5, when I call this, okay, now it will, the control will come over here, right? And now it checks whether any decorator has been applied or not. Okay, this indicates the decorator at the rate of timeit. Okay, timeit is nothing but its function name, the one which we have defined there. Okay, so if it is applied, then it will go to that particular decorator. Okay, and function name is nothing but calc underscore sqr. Okay, this function name parameter is there, right? Is nothing but calc underscore sqr actually. Okay, and then we all know this will not be executed until it is getting invoked. We all know that, right? So, and then it will execute this one, return wrapper. So wrapper is what? It's a function which is defined inside, nested function. Okay, and these indicates the arguments to this function. So this is a generic form of arguments, if you remember. That is n number of positional arguments and n number of keyword arguments. And then inside this, first I am printing the function name dot underscore underscore name underscore underscore. Yesterday we have seen. Okay, it will print the function name here. Then stop time will be calculated, and f return, that is because it is returning something, right? So there should be something to catch it. okay, and then function name, and then I'm calling that. So at this point, the statements will be executed. The set of statements, which is inside calc underscore str, will be executed. Okay, and now it will have, that is, str list will be stored inside f underscore return. Okay, and this is normal statement. This will be passed for 5 seconds, and then we have end is equal to time dot time. That is, it will calculate the end time, and then it will print this. Okay, then return f underscore return. That is, it will be returned over here, and from here it will be returned over here. Here, okay, that is what is happening there. See, now I am in calc SQR. Okay, 5 seconds. And then calc SQR took some, this much is present, okay, and then square of 5 numbers, okay, and then I am in calc cube and took this much of milliseconds to complete, and then cube of 5 numbers, okay. So these are called as decorators. So normally decorators are mostly used in, okay, mostly used in logging and finding the time taken by each and every module. Okay, timing and logging. Only for these two, mostly this particular decorators is being used. Okay, because now if I want to measure some particular performance, okay, it is not required to add each and every line actually. Each and every line, it is not required to add. I have to just define one function. Okay, let me define one function. Okay, let me define one function like check mail ID, okay, and then mail underscore ID, and then I can write if mail ID dot count of at the rate of is equal to 1, all right, and then I can return or else status is equal to valid mail ID, all right, else I can write status is equal to invalid mail ID. And then I can return the status. Okay, return the status. Okay. Now, if I want to measure this particular performance, okay, see, first let me run this. Oh, this is not at all called actually. Sorry. Okay, so I can write print. Check mail ID. Okay, I can say check mail ID of Mohan at the rate of gmail.com. Okay, so now let me execute it again. Oh, invalid syntax. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, see here. CalSpire is being executed. CalCube is being executed. Check mail ID. But for check mail ID, it is not executed. So if I want to measure the performance, I can just add this one. That's it. Timing. That's it. Now it will be executed from the decorator. Okay, see, now I'm in check mail ID. See, check mail ID took this much of seconds, this much of milliseconds to complete, and this is the return value from it. Fine, so this is called decorators actually. Okay, any doubts? Any doubts, guys, in this? Can you move on to the next one? Yeah, it's a kind of annotation. Yes. Okay, fine. So next one, we're going to see generators. Remember tuple comprehension, when we see it used to generate one object. Okay, that's what we are going to see in detail. generators.py. Okay, that is, I can write, okay, def gen or generate location. Generate location. Okay, I can just say yield Bangalore, and similarly yield Chennai, and I can write yield Mumbai, and then I can write yield Kolkata, and then I can write yield Mysore. Okay, I can write like this. So now, okay, now what can I do? Okay, now what can I do? Create the generator object. Generator object. That is, okay, I can say LOC is equal to generate location. That's it. Okay, now if I print this location, okay, if I print this location, what happens here is, okay, if I print this location, what happens here is, you can see generator object generate location at this address. So like tuple comprehension, it is printing the values actually. It is printing the values actually. That is, okay, whenever you say yield, okay, whenever you say yield, it is a kind of return statement. Okay, it's a kind of return statement actually. That is, it is creating the generator object on this name, okay, on this name, and it is starting adding, okay, and it started adding the value to this generator object. Okay, all right, that is, whenever you are using yield, it is creating the generator object with this name, and it started adding the value which you are providing here. Okay, so now let me print that value. Okay, so let me write location one. I can write LOC dot next. Sorry. Excuse me, guys. Excuse me. Okay. Okay, so here we have dot underscore underscore next underscore underscore. Okay. Excuse me, guys. Can I have? I'll go and have some water and come back. Yeah, just give me 2 minutes. Yeah, sorry guys. Okay, so now when I use LOC dot underscore underscore next underscore underscore, okay, okay, so when I use like this, it started receiving the retrieving the location from this particular generator. See, whenever I use first time, it is Bangalore. Okay, and then location 2, location 3, location 4, location 5. Okay, see, location 2 I can write, location 3, location 4, and then location 5. All right, see here, it will retrieve only one by one actually. So you can retrieve the values anywhere in the code. It is not necessary that you should retrieve it at the same time. Okay, you can retrieve anywhere in the code actually. All right, and when I use next time, let's say location 6, okay, now you can see stop iteration error. All right, so now I can say try block, okay. And I can say except, okay, stop iteration, okay, like this. And then I can say all values read, okay, from generator object, okay. And then I can write the name generate location, okay. So I can write like this actually. For example, now you can see, you can't see the error now. You have handled that particular exception. You have handled that particular exception actually. Okay, like this. Okay, so first we need to define a function and yield. Yield is the keyword. Okay, it will create the generator object with the name generate underscore location and it will start adding the location one by one. Okay, and whenever we use this, that generate location object will be copied over here. And using this particular name, we are reading one by one. Okay, and next one we'll see. Now I'm going to define one random function like df y range of n. Like range function is there, right? So like that, I'm going to define some function called y range. Okay. So in this, what I am going to do is like, let's say num is equal to 1. Okay. Num is equal to 1. So while num is less than or equal to, okay, let's have this as max num. Max underscore num. Okay, less than or equal to max underscore num. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to yield num. What I'm going to do is I'm going to yield num and then I'm going to increment it. Okay, yield num. This is a generic function. It's a kind of a range function. Okay, it's a kind of a range function actually. That is, we are simulating the range function. That's it. Okay, we are simulating, kind of simulating the range function. Okay, so now num underscore list, let's say num underscore or numbers, I can say numbers is equal to y range of 10. Okay, numbers is equal to y range of 10. Now what happens? Okay, if you create the generator object, okay, it will create the generator object which has the values from numbers 1 to 10 actually. Okay, see now, like, okay, here let me write create the generator object. Okay, and then retrieve the elements from the generator. Okay, all right. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to have try block. Okay, try block. That is, I can write while of one. Okay, while of one. I can print current number. Okay, I can write numbers dot underscore underscore next underscore underscore, like this. All right, so whenever there is no value, okay, stop iteration. Whenever there is no value in the generator object, I can say print all numbers read from generator object, like numbers, I can say or Y range. Or Y range. Okay. Now what happens? Can anybody guess? Now it will just print from 1 to 10. See, 1 to 10. It will print and then it is giving all numbers read from generator object. That is, instead of giving like dot underscore underscore next underscore underscore, I am just giving it in a loop. That's it. Okay, I am just giving it in a loop actually. So I am reading all the numbers at once. That is, within the loop itself, I am reading all the numbers. Alright. Okay. So now this is just the generator object. So let me try changing this to a list. Okay, let's change it to a list actually. So num list is equal to list of y range of 10. Okay, let me print num underscore list. So here you can see. So this is like range function only. Right, this is like range function only. That is, range function, if you give maximum number, it will not include. See, for example, let me write minimum number. Okay, minimum number. That is, if I say range of 1, 6, what is happening? What is happening? It is printing from 1 to 5, right? So, let's replicate the same thing actually. Min num, okay? Let's say min num is equal to 1 is the default, okay? Alright, so let's do like this. Okay. Okay, so now, okay, let's have the same thing. Min num is equal to 0, max num. Okay, so this is the same as like range function. Okay, this is the same as like range function. Okay, so I can't give it like this, right? Because it will throw error. It will throw error actually, right? Okay, so now what can I do? Let me just give this one, okay? And then let me give 1, 10. And here I can give step num. Step num, okay? So by default, let it be 1. By default, let it be 1 actually. I can give here step num. Alright, so 1, 10. So now what happens? By default, it's like a it's like from 1 to 10 it will be printed. Sorry, 1 to 9 will be printed now. See now. Sorry, missing one required question argument. Okay, so here I didn't give this. Alright. So let me give 1, 10 here as well. Now you can see until 9 it will be printed. It is like range object only now. Okay, it is like range object only, right? So now let me say 1, 11 here. 1, 11 and then 2 and here let me give 1, 2, 11, 2. Okay, now you can see 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So we are replicating the range function here. Okay, using generator, we are simulating the functionality of range function. Alright guys, understood? Understood? Okay, using generator, we have just replicated the range function. Okay, alright. Any doubts, guys? Okay, Ramakrishnan is fine. How about others? Meghna is fine, Rashmi is fine, Sandhya is fine. Yeah, we have only 4 participants. Yeah. Okay, guys, so that's the end of the session today. Okay, so we have seen 3 important concepts. One is regular expression, generators, and decorators. Okay. So, as usual, let me just upload this. Okay, so if we just unmute all of you. Yeah, so you all unmuted. So now I'm going to upload that to LMS. And tomorrow we are going to see CGI programming and database access both together, okay? So tomorrow we are going to see database access and then CGI programming. So session 6 files. So choose file, basics, open, submit. Okay guys, so it's uploaded. So what about the assignment? You guys are doing it, right? Okay, fine guys, fine, fine. Okay, guys,
and, so yeah, I have a small query actually. So you are talking about project in the initial.
Yeah.
So what is that actually after the course? So it will be completing in Saturday. So how long the project will go on and what is the procedure?
No. Actually, the problem statement will be sent by ops team from screen people.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And then it's like you have to work on that project, and if you have any queries you can make me. It's like you can mail to ops@linkable.com and then they will let you.
Like how we have got assignments assignment on Monday, that is how it will be, or
I think it will be separated, I think, because I don't know that particular like how you guys should be getting the project actually. So it will be sent via mail, I think.
Okay. How, any other assignments we'll be getting?
Yes. So tomorrow you'll be getting some assignments.
Okay.
Yeah. You can submit by this weekend, guys. No problem. Ramakrishna and Meghna, you can submit the assignment by this weekend. No issues at all. Okay. Okay, guys.
Okay,
guys. Thank you, and thanks for your time today. So, good night to everyone. And tomorrow, the same time we will meet. Okay, same time. That is at 8:30 we will meet. All right. Yeah. Okay, guys. Shall we wind up? Yeah. Okay, guys. Thank you. Good night to everyone. Have a great day tomorrow. Bye.